JPS is hosting a two-day COVID-19 vaccination blitz.
JPS hosts a Teens in Crisis Forum for students, teachers, and parents focusing on mental health.
Jackson Public Schools and William Carey University celebrated a three-year partnership today with...
Jackson Public Schools started graduation ceremonies.
I can't believe it's time for convocation already. We're about to start this new school year. Teachers come back today. Just a few more days and our scholars will be back. This year's theme is One District, One Direction, Marching Towards Excellence. We need to live that. Last year we had some of the best graduation rates ever. Wonder how high we can go this year. Geez, there's so much that we have done and want to do this next year. I gotta remind our teachers and all of our staff members to pace themselves. I just met some new pre-K parents over the summer. You could see it all in their faces. They were so excited for their young children to join us. Just thinking about all those scholars who are looking forward to having a safe place to go and making sure that they get some great meals. And it's all the things that schools are to our scholars. It's so much more than just learning how to read. One District, One Direction, Marching Towards Excellence. We gotta make it true. Marching Towards Excellence. Marching Towards Excellence. Marching Towards Excellence. One District, One, district. One, district. One Direction, One direction. Marching, marching, marching towards excellence. 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 Excellence.
little dramatic. A little drama don't hurt you. Well, good morning. Well, good morning. You know, I'm repeating good morning to allow me to catch my breath a little bit. I was like, that's a long way from back there. Good morning, Team JPS. Is so exciting to be with you. I'm so pleased to have this opportunity to greet you and just to be a part of what's happening here in Jackson Public Schools. Can you feel it? Can you feel the energy in this room? Come on now, y'all don't act like you feel the energy in this room. Every aspect of this morning ceremony, this program, just oozes with pride, excellence. And so I so thank you for just being a part of this wonderful team, this wonderful work at this amazing time. Happy New Year! Something delighted to welcome you all back to another school year this fall and to have this opportunity to address you as one district, heading in one direction, marching towards excellence. Now, I won't take long with the thanks, but the thanks are many. Everyone who had a hand in creating this morning's program, everyone who had a hand in providing for the logistics, or all of those who participated on stage, all of the energy and love that we felt and heard from each and every one of you all around the stadium, just appreciate each and every bit of it. I want to thank Dr. Denton and to all of the Unity Chorus, to our JPS All-City Band. Wasn't that amazing? Aren't they amazing? Thank you, Mr. Little. We know that it's not a simple thing to bring all these talented folks from all these different places together to do one thing at one time, but that's really what we're about, and that's what this year is about. All of these talented people coming together to do amazing work together. Of course, we want to thank our friends here at Jackson State University. President Hudson had to step away to manage some other items, but we do thank him, thank the team here for all of their continued support, and President Hudson and all of his colleagues for their continued commitment to education. That's pre-K through higher education. So let's give them a round of applause and thanks. I want to thank our illustrious mayor, Lumumba, who too had to go on a deal with some other matters, but for being here this morning and bringing us greetings. Mayor Lumumba has been a staunch supporter and protector of Jackson Public Schools for the entire time that I've been here, and certainly before. And he's made no bones about that. He is very much so supportive of our district and proud of the work that we're doing. And so I want to thank Mayor Lumumba and the city of Jackson, the broader community. Of course, we also want to thank all of our elected officials who are here. They've been recognized. Just thank you for taking time out this morning. We know you could have been anywhere else doing a million other things, but you chose to be here with us celebrating Jackson Public Schools and all of the amazing work that's happening in our district. Also, of course, want to thank all of my board members. You all show up. You really show up for us. I don't know if you all watch any board meetings, but religiously, our board members push us hard and ask us the questions that they should be asking, looking for the evidence of success and the markers that we'll use to challenge ourselves to get even higher, reach even higher, even higher. And they do that with love and with respect, and they demonstrate it religiously, regularly. And so I do thank you, board members, all of you, for being here this morning and for your ongoing support. And lastly, folks, because I rarely have this opportunity, I want to take a point of personal privilege to thank my mom, who happens to be here visiting from Michigan, along with my aunt, for her never-ending support and encouragement. Yeah, I can say a lot about Ella Greene Moten. I won't this morning, but just so appreciate you and thank you for your support. JPS family, we are indeed rising. Y'all know that, right? That's not news to you, is it? We are indeed rising. And so let me share just a few stats for those who might be slow to believe. So this, right? Because they'll get there. It's just, you know, some people, you gotta love them. Just gotta love them. What is it? What's that Southern? Bless your heart. Bless your Yo, I'm saying that all day, every day. Bless your heart. Okay, moving on. So, stat number one, and you heard a mention of this earlier. First, JPS has increased our graduation rate from 70.2 to 84.6%. That's 14 percentage points. But y'all, the kicker, in 5 years, we've had that level of growth. In 5 years, we've also stretched the $65 million that were voted on in the bond referendum to well over $72 million, right? Do the math. Seven additional millions of dollars that we've been able to use to further enhance our facilities and to do some, make some long overdue investments in our schools. And I know we've got more to do, but we're just thankful to the public, to the community, for that vote of confidence and just pleased to have had that opportunity to make those enhancements. We've also doubled, more than doubled, the number of pre-K seats here in Jackson Public Schools, and that's huge. That's a huge investment of resources, investment of talent, political might. Not everybody believes that we should be providing free pre-K quality, high quality pre-K to all of our babies. But we as educators know better. And so I'm so thankful to all of the work that our team has done to expand pre-K seats, and not just to expand, but to increase the quality of the pre-K learning experiences for our four-year-old Jacksonians. And then lastly, you know, I'll say this in hushed tones because we don't want this to get out, because, you know, people start beating up on you when you rise. But through lots of really hard work and dedication, a laser-like focus on teaching and learning. Yep, that's what we do here in Jackson Public Schools, right? And with deep and meaningful partnerships with one another and with our external partners, our preliminary data, where's my attorney? Watch my words, check me. Okay, our preliminary data, I said it twice, I'm gonna say it again, because just in case this gets cut up and spliced, our preliminary data shows. That we've made significant improvements in student performance. Okay, y'all know how this goes, right? So we got some really good data. We're excited to talk about it. We'll talk about it as soon as we can in specifics, but just know that however it shakes out, we're crunching numbers and checking our data and rechecking it and checking it with the other people and all of that kind of business. But just know that any way you slice it, we are killing the game in Jackson Public Schools. Run till that. Run till that. Run till that. That's right, I said it. I salute you, Team JPS. I salute you. You make me so, so proud. So, so proud. Give yourselves a round of applause. So as you know, our theme for this year, one district, one direction, marching towards excellence. And when we reflect on our accomplishments to date, we have to ask ourselves how we got here. Or as the old folks would say, not you, Mom, not talking about you, the old folks. how we got over. We thankfully can answer that question with confidence. We didn't just get lucky. How many of you know that? We didn't just get lucky. There was no magic spell that created those wins that we've achieved. And there was certainly no superhero to come to save the day. We worked as one district team, moving in the same direction, and that being our strategic plan, Excellence for All. In that plan, we outlined our vision and mission, our core values and commitments, and the goals to which we'd hold ourselves accountable. We developed a plan as a roadmap to success. And I firmly believe that because we've been steadfast in following that map, we've achieved a level of success. One of the things that I know about any high-performing team is that they act with focus. Think about any great athletic team that you might have, and we want to ask you to name your favorite teams because I know we could be here all morning. Any great athletic team, or award-winning band or troupe, or even birds flying in formation, think about the way they move with focus and precision. There's a clear objective that they've developed and a rhythm that they have, and each member knows it. The individuals on these teams know their roles, and they know that they can't accomplish their goals on their own. I don't care how amazing any one member might be, success can only be found in the focused efforts of a united and resolute body. You know what, Team JPS? I say, you know what, JPS? Glad you asked. We've come a long way. We've come a long way in that regard of working together and working together as a team. Just in the 4 years that I've been here, the level of collaboration, of focus, has been nothing short of remarkable. And I know that we haven't fully arrived yet. I know that we sometimes forget our way, our ideas, and our needs are not the only important ones in the room. Sometimes we lose sight of the fact that this school district, our very jobs, exist solely for the purpose of serving scholars and families. That's our compelling why, and we can't ever forget that. And the moment we think it's all about us as individuals and not about the masses that we serve, or even the team on which we serve, ladies and gentlemen, we've lost. As we reflect on the power of the collective, I want to share just a few quotes that speak to this very theme of unity and oneness. Kipling, who's was an English journalist and novelist, once said, "For the strength of the pack is the wolf, and the strength of the wolf is the pack." Andrew Carnegie was a Scottish-American who led the steel industry in expansion. He's also a great philanthropist. He once wrote, "Teamwork is the ability to work together towards a common vision, the ability to direct individual accomplishments toward organizational objectives. It is the fuel that allows common people to attain uncommon results." Margaret Mead was an American cultural anthropologist, and she penned one of my favorite quotes, "Never doubt that a small group of thoughtful, committed citizens can change the world. Indeed, it's the only thing that ever has." And then lastly, Bishop Desmond Tutu, South African priest and theologian, he was also a human rights and anti-apartheid activist. He said this, I want you to listen to this very closely. He said, "Do your little bit of good where you are. It's those little bits of good put together that overwhelm the world. And I know, colleagues, you may be asking, what does this mean for me? So my question to you is, what is that little bit of good that you will do on behalf of our scholars? What is that special talent that you bring? The assignment given especially to you, the role that only you can hold. You know, I've been asked that, what are we doing to help address the crime in our city? And this question sometimes puts me off because it seems to demonstrate the lack of understanding and faith in the power of the work that we do. As educators, we're showing young people that they have worth and that they can dream big dreams and make them real. We're marching daily, minute by minute, hour by hour, towards excellence. We're helping to create possibilities for young people who might not otherwise have them. We're changing the trajectory of their lives by helping them to live more fully. We are literally transforming the lives of our scholars, their families, and communities by pouring hope and promise into them. This is what we're doing to help combat crime in our community. We're educating young people not just for today, not just for tomorrow, but to live more fully today. And we're preparing them to go out into the world and achieve globally, contribute locally, and to be fulfilled individually. That's our vision, that's our commitment, that's our charge. Team JPS, this school year brings a whole new opportunity to literally change lives. Last year was tough. I mean, really tough. And who knows what challenges this year will bring? But we've got this. Y'all, we've got this. Just as long as we work as one district with one direction and continue our march towards excellence. Let's have a wonderful, wonderful school year.